Okay, so here's the first lick. So what we've got here is we're on the A string and we're going to play 7-5-7. Then on the D string, we've got 5-7 bend up to 9. So far it should sound like this. Now, if you can't manage a bend, you could just slide up to the 9. It's the same thing. Then you want to go back to the 7 on the D string. So it should be this. Or this. And then fret 5 on the A string twice. So just to recap, lick 1. Okay, so let's take a look at lick number 2. Okay, so we're based around the E minor pentatonic position 1. And what we've got is a rake across strings G and B, and then we want to hit 12, 14, 15 on the high E. Now, a rake, if you can see my right hand, is like a sweep. And then on the B string, we've got 15, 12, 13. So far you should have this. And then the last part of lick 2, I slide up to the 15, play 12th fret on the high E, then bend 15 up to pitch of fret 17 and then play 15 twice. So that last bit should sound like this. Sorry. So all together, lick 2. Okay, so let's take a look at lick number 3. It's a bit of a rhythmic riff, this one. We've got two mutes, rhythmic mutes, like obviously we're not playing all the strings, just on strings G and B again. And then we want to play fret 12 on the G and the B string. So I'm using my first finger to bar fret 12. Then we've got part of like an A minor 7 type thing, well, an A minor chord. We've got 14 and 13, so 14 on the G and 13 on the B, but again they're played together in unison. So together, so far it should sound like this. And then we go back to fret 12. So. And then there's one mute again before playing fret 11 on the G. So far it should sound like this. Sorry, no, there is two mutes, the same. And then we've got fret 12 on the D and the A string. So again, slowly. Sorry, I forgot to mention that 11 on the G, you want to bend it a bit. up to the pitch of fret 12. Okay, so let's take a look at lick number 4. Now you may have noticed already that it's very similar to lick 2. Starts the same way, we've got a rake up to fret 12 on the high E, followed by 14 and 15 on the high E. Then we've got 15, 12, 13 on the B. But then this time, we're going back to the 12 on the B, and then 12 on the G. So far it should be like this. And then we finish off this lick with a bend on the 15th fret. Two bends on the 15th fret. So again, slowly. Okay, and the last and final lick for the solo. Okay, this is the hardest part of the solo, obviously, because of the amount of notes and how quickly they're played. But don't be too discouraged, because, you know, I mean, as long as you hit that last high bend on that last beat, whatever came before it is kind of forgotten. So, you know, that's the moneymaker there. So, what we have for the last lick is 14, 16, 17 on the G string, which for those of you that know your major scale or your minor scale, whatever you want to call it, is part of position 7. Or Locrian, as some people call it. So we've got 14, 16, 17 on the G. And then we've got a little chromatic bit on the B string. We've got 15, 16, 17. And then we've got just like a pentatonic lick to finish. So to recap, we've got 14, 16, 17 on the G. 15, 16, 17 on the B. And then we go back to 15 on the B, 17 on the B, 15 on the E, and 17 on the B, on the E, with a bend. Up to the pitch of the 19th fret. So it's a whole tone bend. So rhythmically, it's played 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4. If you can't manage to pick them all, don't worry too much. You can, I think it's even tabbed this way, just use like legato technique. So pick the first fret or the first note, the 14 on the G, and then hammer on the 16 and the 17. So I'm only picking that the once. And then again for the next string down, we've got 15, 16, 17, but only pick the 15. Which can in itself be, you know, good to learn for your legato technique. And then finish off with. Okay, so I hope you've enjoyed this video lesson. And if you subscribe to my page, there's bound to be many more video lessons like this in the future. Okay, thanks.